Hey everyone, it's Vincent Von Dyke, and welcome to King Me, Rise of a Drag King. Keep it up, we can dance all night, don't stop, we'll be winning this fight. Rise up, till the sun comes up, and the sun comes up. Cause we're the cool kids, we're starting this movement. We're the cool kids, you better get used to it. This week, we challenged our contestants to bring us their best nude illusion. So everyone's gonna get naked. Let's see what you got.
Een kruzifix nochmal. Wie könnte das sein? Ich hab niemanden bestellt. Wer klingelt denn jetzt und stört mich bei Dusche? Da geh ich mal schnell schau. Jetzt hat es schon wieder geklingelt. Aber bevor ich gehe, gieße ich noch mal kurz die Blümchen.
How you doing? Are you ready to bear it all? Can you bear it? Oh, I can barely stand it. Yeah, baby, yeah.
Come on and hold me tight. I love you. Wild thing, you make my heart sing. You make everything. Thank you. think you move me.
Hey, yeah.
World. And although most men are hoes, he flows on the down low, cause I never heard about him with another girl. But I don't sweat it, because it's just pathetic to let it get me involved in that he said, she said crowd. I know that ain't nobody perfect, I give props to those who deserve it, and believe me, y'all, he's worth it. So here's to the future, cause we got through the past, I finally found somebody that could make me laugh. You so crazy, I think I wanna have your baby.
Alright guys, Joey here. Sorry I can't stop for long tonight, I'm actually off out on a date. Met someone on Tinder, yep. Said they were a little bit kinky. Was intrigued, you know what I mean? Told me they were into water sports. Nice. Can't say I've done it before, but I'm pretty sure I know what it is. Gonna be a good night, man. Mum, where's my swimming gear? What do you mean you donated it? I swim. I work out. I do exercise. What am I meant to do? I need it now. Fine, I'll improvise. Oh, fuck's sake. What else floats? I'm all ready. Rocking the Italian stallion.
Hey baby, God, you're even hotter than your picture. That like never happens. Yeah, I am ready for water sports. Do you want me to get the lilo or? Wait, what? What are you?
No! Water sports wasn't what I thought it was. I'm never drinking apple juice again.
Standing on it's a great way to ensure you get the actual grid. Okay, hold that just for a second and I'll just test the light on it. Right. Move this tiny bit around. There we go, right. It's always the way the focus gets right, there we go. And in your face. Gonna work quite nicely. Can you pull it back over?
Elegant tee shots.
Elegant tee shots. Sorry. Draping like
like a Grecian.
Like a Grecian toga. I'm gonna get myself.
Remember, not delicate. Manly.
Yep. That's a brilliant pose. Hold that. Jeez, if you were running for office right now, this is what you would want on your campaign poster.
I am.
Let me just show you.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
That is really cool. Okay, we'll do another couple and I think we'll get you to further across. Really show off that face contouring. Okay, great.
annoyed with my tape, though.
Well, we can put the non-edited shots in and then just smooth that out to show the intention of it.
Yeah. It's because it got a load of powder in it.
Yeah.
Good damn. Oh well.
So cool.
Fuck.
At least that's perfect.
Yeah.
Mhm. Could you have your left hand also up so it's like you're supporting the entire thing above? Yeah. And this is going to sound really strange, but could you squat down at the same time? I think you're okay.
I'm exposing a lot to that camera.
No, you're fine for this one.
Sorry, yeah, guys.
There may need to be some tactical editing.
There you go.
Yeah, I like that.
Hang on, let me just...
Yeah, get your arm visible. Finicky fabrics.
Yeah. Oh, for fuck's sake. Great, because I kind of have a reflection from the camera.
Yeah.
So I know what's going
on. Slide this up ever so slightly, just there. And could you raise your left elbow just like 3 centimeters? Yeah, perfect. Brilliant.
Hi, King Me. It's Maddie. I am minutes away from getting into my nude illusion to take some pictures for you. I know there's no video requirement for this challenge, but I wanted to just film something really quick for you guys anyway. Probably because I'm a little self-conscious about all this. I remember seeing all the lists of all of the competitions that we're going to have to do, and I remember nude illusion just terrified me. I'm not a person that enjoys being naked, and that's just not something that I'm very, I don't know, confident in. I've lost 160 pounds in my lifetime, so it's, my body is something that I don't always show off in that way, so I kind of had to go a different route with this than, you know, most kings, and I feel like a lot of kings I see will be able to paint on themselves and do that sort of drag, and that's just not an option for me. And I know it's actually not an option for a lot of other kings, so it's kind of cool that maybe I can relate to some people in that way. Basically, I just tried my hardest on this, and I think that you're going to really enjoy it, and I think I learned a lot in doing this, doing something that's terrified me. My challenge that was I was most nervous for, I think, I ended up really doing something great with it. And, like, thank you for that. So, yeah, I mean, I guess here goes nothing. We'll talk soon, hopefully.
Here it's we happening. Go!
Oh my god.
I have money, right there.
Money.
Make the snow angel. Make the snow angel.
Money.
Right there. Oh, fucking A, right, Maddie?
I am Scotland.
Woo! Spencer Money Challenge 8!
The ice bucket challenge?
No. The ice bucket challenge and scene!
These are so good.
I love it when you get naked!
Our guest judge this challenge is none other than Matt Finish. He is a famous burlesquer and he knows all about getting naked.
Hey everyone, this is Matt Finish. I'm your Mr. Exotic World 2015. I'm also the producer of Don't Blink Burlesque and the Arizona Burlesque Festival. I can't wait to judge this week's Nude Illusion Challenge. So let's talk about Hans Schwanz for a minute. I felt like this was a little bit of a cop-out. What I saw was a whole lot of costume, a lot of clothing, and a plastic chest torso plate. Considering this was a Nude Illusion Challenge, I don't think that it was that successful. To start off with, there was just so much coverage. The hat, the bandana, the robe especially, covering all of the arms, a lot of the chest, all of the side of the body, the back of the body, a lot of the legs. There was boxers and socks and shoes. I wanted to see more skin. You know, I wanted to see down the side of the body. I wanted to see legs and arms. I wanted to see nudity for the Nude Illusion Challenge, and I don't think that I saw it here. So I thought the story was cute. The photo set's okay. The strongest photo is definitely the first one. The shower photo is pretty good. I wish that that had been a lengthwise photo, hugging the shower curtain, kind of dodging the chest with the curtain down the side of the body all the way down to the legs. And I thought that would have been showing a lot more skin and would have been much closer to a nude illusion than what we got from Hans. I don't think the story was enough to save this one.
Hans Schwanz, great use of a chest plate. You really teased us with this video, but I would have loved it if you'd gone a bit further. I wanted to see the goodies. I did enjoy you watering your plants, though. Good work, man.
Okay, let's talk about Hugh Johnson. I really liked this. I thought that the photo set was funny. It had a very Burt Reynolds kind of feel, with all the body hair and the flowers and the suggestive posing. I don't think I can do this particular challenge justice without mentioning the presence of Wang. There was definitely a Wang, and it took me by surprise and scared me a little bit. I thought this was a really great nude illusion. I thought that the tone matching was good. I thought the body contour was on point. I almost wish that there hadn't been quite so much body hair. In the video, when we see Hugh preparing, we get to see the full body illusion with the muscles and everything, and a lot of that work got obscured by all that heavy, heavy body hair. I don't know if that's a regular part of your character or not, but I thought that the body alone was really, really strong. The hair was also nice, but I don't know that it was as necessary in this particular challenge. I thought this was extremely well executed. Hugh, you are charming. You're handsome. I'd like to see more of you. I've seen a lot. But I thought this was really well done. Good job, Hugh.
Hi, stranger. It's been a while. I've missed you. It's okay. You can look at my butt. Hi, Hugh. You got naked. You went into the woods. I loved it. You really, really went for it. It was exactly what we were looking for. Full body contour. Good work, Hugh Johnson.
Okay, so let's talk about Joey Bambino. I thought this was so cute. The story was ridiculous. I loved it. The date, the water sports, the trauma, the very well-placed use of censorship. I thought the body was pretty good. I thought the nude illusion was decent. There were some inconsistencies in proportion and things, especially across the top, where you could see the edge of the muscle plate that was a little distracting underneath the shirt. I also wish that he had taken the chest hair above the necklace. I don't personally know any men that only shave their beards down to the level of their necklace, maybe the collarbones, but that was a little bit distracting. I thought the face was good. I liked the creative use of balloons. I thought it was a clever way to cover sensitive areas. The photos, I really like the underwater photo. For me, that was my favorite out of all of them. Very Aquaman. The posing with the cast of the new Baywatch film. And then the pool shot, of course. I would have been interested to see a terrified look maybe on the bed or wherever these water sports were occurring, perhaps in a shower. Or I don't know. I don't know how that date went.
Joey Bambino, I'm really impressed with you. You really pushed yourself outside your comfort zone. It's true, you do not need to get naked to be a drag king. But you dove right in. Splishy splashy. And I really love the use of humour. And the very sexy body hair. Well done, Joey Bambino.
So, Max Ryder's photos. This was a very high concept nude illusion. The use of minimalist props. The black and white photos. There wasn't as much of a photo story going on so much as this was an art project kind of exploring the idea of soft and strong body image, gender identity. It was interesting. That being said, it didn't all quite work. I thought in a few of the photos where the shadows were heavier, the black and whites in particular, the frontal black and whites, and the one shot coming up the stairs, the chest looked a bit odd. I understand that Max has been working with his proportions, but I think the super high contrast shadows only emphasized how much tissue is there. I really liked the poses with the blue fabric. I thought they kind of had that old gladiator warrior look about them. In particular, holding it across the lower body, which is, of course, a great way to obscure sensitive areas. And across, I thought the strongman pose was really wonderful. Some of the more feminine poses were a bit distracting. We lose the sense of masculinity that I think is probably called for in a drag king challenge. Anytime you cross the legs and close the body that way, you emphasize curves. You end up with the chest stuck out, with the hips stuck back, and it looks very, very feminine. I thought the shot over the face was wonderful. Is it a nude illusion? Well, no. It was just art. It was beautiful art, but I don't know particularly what that has to do with nudity. I thought the mirror shots with all of the different words written on the body was beautiful. I thought that was very powerful. I thought it was a great image. I'm a little torn over this nude illusion because when I take my clothes off in front of an audience, it's fun and happy and light, and it's the whole point is entertainment and to get them cheering and laughing. This nudity made me think and made me really evaluate the different ways that one could approach a nude illusion challenge. And I think that that speaks to Max's creativity. I like this one. I don't know that I loved it, but I'm really interested to see more of what Max Ryder is going to do in this competition.
Max Ryder, I loved all of your dynamic positions and your angles and shapes. You really brought a statue to life. It was a fantastic move. I think you should be very, very proud of the work you've produced this time round. And you gave us a little flashback to your first performance that you gave us too. And I like that. Good work. The only thing I'm going to say is that you should never let anyone tell you that boobs will get in the way of being a drag king. Because they don't. They don't stop you from owning your masculinity or your maleness. Your body is beautiful. Own it. Well done, Max.
That goddamn snow angel. Spencer. You were so successful from the waist up. What happened to the waist down? There was all this time spent on painting the bodysuit. Painting this shiny golden bodysuit, which, by the way, you should have used a matte finish. Painting muscles and contour on, and then there was nothing. There were no legs. They were shiny gold sausages. I would have liked to have seen, if you're, it's a nude illusion, so it's not just about the upper body. It is about the entire body. And it wasn't entirely successful because there was such an abundance of definition up top, and there was just smooth down below. I really liked the idea behind the photo shoot. I thought it was adorable. I thought the photos were actually quite good. I really liked especially all of the ones standing up, kind of shrugging into the white fur cape with the earmuffs and money everywhere. Also, you know, I have not encountered too many people in my lifetime that are Barbie dolls. Down below, it was entirely smooth. So in some cases where it was hidden with money, that was successful, but there were a few shots when you were directly crotch to camera with nothing covering, and that would be not a successful nude illusion because there's nothing there. I love your energy. I think that your confidence is amazing. I would not want to go rolling around in the snow at all. I'm from Tucson, Arizona. I like it warm. I like it hot. I ain't playing in no snow, so I commend you on that, and I hope that going forward from here, you are able to take the knowledge that you just did this and put it to good use and productively in your other endeavors. I thought this was a pretty good nude illusion, but like I said, lower body needs to be included, and if you're not going to cover, you have to have something there.
Spend some money. Well done indeed. I know you found this one tough, a lot of people do. But you went for it, and you got out there. You not only braved the challenge, but you braved the cold too. Nice snow angel. The only thing I'm going to say, if you're going to wear a body stocking, make sure it's a tight one. You don't want to be baggy in the old nether regions. Looks a bit weird. Apart from that, you smashed it. Nice one, Spencer.
Your winner this week is Hugh Johnson. Hugh won a nude illusion bodysuit and chest plate from none other than Spikey Van Dyke. Congratulations, Hugh Johnson.
In the arms of the angel, fly away.
Next week, we're challenging our contestants to sell us a tool with a commercial. Want a screw? Be sure to catch us every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. Mountain Standard Time to catch a new episode of King Me. Let's see you next time on King Me, Rise of a Drag King. We're the cool kids.